गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू अनदर वीडियो। एज यू ऑलरेडी सीन द टॉपिक फॉर टुडेज, सो आई फील नो नीड टू टेल दैट अगेन। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी टाइम, लेट्स सी व्हाट आई गॉट टुडे। Chaos in the Korea sees Kim Jong-un's sisters emerge stronger than ever. On a crisp winter day 2 years ago, Kim Yo-jong took her first step to becoming the powerful politician her father thought she would be. It was February 10, 2018, the youngest child of former North Korean leader Kim Jong-il had already made history by becoming the first member of her family since the end of the Korean War to set foot in the southern half of the Korean Peninsula. The night before, she had attended the opening ceremony of the Winter Olympics in Pyeongchang, South Korea. She sat behind South Korean President Moon Jae-in and watched as hundreds of athletes marched together under a flag representing a unified Korea, a country carved in half in the aftermath of World War II by the Soviet Union and the United States, with little regards for the thousands of families that were split apart. Kim applauded these athletes alongside dignitaries like Moon, US President Mike Pence, and Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe. It was a tremendous photo op, but a trip to the Blue House, South Korea's presidential residence, was a whole different ballgame. Kim Yo-jong would be the first member of North Korea's ruling family ever to enter the hall of power of a sworn enemy. The morning after the opening ceremony, Kim exited a black sedan to enter the Blue House. She ambled down a red carpet with immaculate posture and her head held high, exuding the confidence of a woman who had been meeting important world leaders for years. She dressed all in black and clutched a black briefcase in her left hand, dark tones that all drew attention to the red label pinned over her heart, emblazoned with the faces of her smiling father and grandfather. As she approached the building's threshold, she paused and, out of the corner of her eye, looked to her left. Then she slowed her gait to allow the man by her side, a non-agenarian named Kim Yong-nam, who was North Korea's ceremonial head of the state at the time, to enter first, adhering to Confucian values of respecting one's elder despite the fact her family is reserved with near religious fervor back home. Kim Yo-jong was North Korea's chief propagandist at the time, and her ability to craft an image was on full display in Seoul. She proved to be perfect emissary for her country, a savvy urban operator who could counter the narrative of her homeland as a strange, backward, nuclear-armed relic of the Cold War that allegedly holds more than 1 lakh people in forced labor camps. Park Ji-won, a former South Korean lawmaker, a presidential chief of staff, said after 4 meetings with Kim Yo-jong, he came away with the impressions of a woman whose intelligence and quiet confidence was beyond her years. She takes after her father and brother, said Park. She is very smart and quick thinking. She is courteous, yet speaks her position clearly. Kim left after 3 days and would be credited for helping lay the groundwork for the first summit between Moon and her older brother, North Korean leader Kim Jong-un. She was, after all, the one who extended his invitation. But the trip also set the stage for something else, a development that's only become clear in the past several days, that Kim Yo-jong was about to become the boss when it came to North Korea's relations with South Korea, and arguably the second most powerful figure in the country, answerable only to Kim Jong-un. Thank you for watching the video. If you like it, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Thank you and have a nice day.